Good morning, everyone. So last time we have already started with the natural heritage topic. So today we'll continue with this particular topic. Okay. So last time we have studied about the natural heritage. I have explained you that what actual natural heritage is. Natural heritage क्या है? उसके बाद हमने ये study किया था कि कौन से different types के sources हैं जिनके ऊपर history जो है based होती है. Then we have studied about the oral sources of the history, written sources of the history, and material sources of the history. We have also studied that how the these historical sources are maintained. That means what is the procedure to maintain all these sources. Now today we'll start with the some famous museums. That means see. Museums are also one of the important and integral part of the heritage management. Heritage management का एक important and integral part जो है क्या है museum है. Now we'll see some famous museum. सब famous museum हम अभी पढ़ने वाले हैं. So I'll share the PPT on the screen और we'll see some of the famous museums. So museums were created to organize and manage the antiquities collected by the members of royal elite family of the medieval period. Now, how these museums have been started? Museums कैसे start हुए? उनका क्या reason था? मतलब उनकी antiquities, that means whatever the things they are using. For example, their clothes, their war equipments, then their accessories, jewelries. All these are very antiques. That means उस जमाने में ये सब चीजों को क्या होता था बहुत एंटिक्स था एंड दैट्स व्हाई दीस म्यूजियम्स हैज बीन क्रिएटेड एंड टू ऑर्गेनाइज यानी कि उन राजा महाराजाओं को म्यूजियम में क्या किया जाता था मेंटेन किया जाता था और एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन दीज आर द सम इंपॉर्टेंट म्यूजियम्स जो हम लोग म्यूजियम्स में चीजें को एग्जिबिट किया जाता है एंड दे हैव बीन मेंटेन उनको मेंटेन किया जाता है नाउ द एज यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन The Louvre Museum, France. The Louvre Museum, France was established in the 18th century. Antiquities collected by the member of the royal families were exhibited in the Louvre Museums. It included the much acclaimed painting of Mona Lisa, as you can see on the screen also. In your right hand side, the picture of painting of Mona Lisa is there. Now, Mona Lisa, a painting by Leonardo Capri. ओके बहुत ज्यादा फेमस है इनकी पेंटिंग तो उसको जो है क्या है वहां पे जो है क्या है रखा गया है एंड अगेन बाय सॉरी द लियोनार्डो विंसी द वर्ल्ड रिनाउन्ड आर्टिस्ट ही वर्क अंडर द पेट्रोनेज ऑफ फ्रांसिस वन द किंग ऑफ फ्रांस इन 16th सेंचुरी द कलेक्शन ऑफ द लेवरे म्यूजियम इंक्रीज टू बी द ग्रेट एक्सटेंट बिकॉज ऑफ द एंटीक्विटीज brought back by Napoleon Bonaparte from this conquest. Presently, the museum contains more than 3,80,000 artifacts. Now, this is first museum. Then, second museum, British Museum, England. England में है ये जो और जो जो फ्रांस का म्यूजियम अभी जो हमने पढ़े हैं ये वाला म्यूजियम लोवरे म्यूजियम फ्रांस में जो है इसमें जो है मोस्ट ऑफ द टाइम नेपोलियन बोनापार्ट ने जो पूरी दुनिया से जो चीजों को कलेक्ट करके लेकर आए थे ड्यूरिंग हिज कॉन्केस्ट ऑल दोस थिंग्स वेर केप्ट इन दिस पर्टिकुलर म्यूजियम सो दैट्स व्हाई देयर इज एन नंबर ऑफ आर्टिफैक्ट्स यू कैन सी फ्रॉम ऑल ओवर द वर्ल्ड इन दिस पर्टिकुलर म्यूजियम नियरली हाउ मेनी आर्टिफैक्ट्स आर देयर 3,80,000 आर्टिफैक्ट्स आर देयर इन दिस पर्टिकुलर म्यूजियम Next is British Museum, England. The British Museum in London was established in 18th century. Sir Hans Sloane, a natural scientist, handed over about 71,000 objects in his collection to the King of England, George II. It included several books, pictures, specimen of preserved plants, herbarium, etc. Later, the collection was expanded by the addition of various art objects and ancient artifacts. Collected by British people from British colonies. Now see, this British Museum. Name of the museum itself is the British Museum. It's in situated in London. It's established in the year 18th century. See how old this museum is. And 71,000 objects se jo iska collection start hua tha during the King George II. Then uske baad jab when the British democracy came into existence in England, uske baad jab British jo hai dusre jo deshon ko colonies banati thi. For example, India was also the colony of the British. So at that time, they used to collect the different things from the different parts of the world, and they used to keep in this particular museum. Presently, the museum collection comprises with about 80 lakhs objects. How many objects are there? 80 lakh objects are there in this particular museum. Then next is National Museum of Natural History, United States, America. Now, this particular museum is entirely for the history and historical museum is there, this particular museum. Now, this museum is in America. The Museum of Natural History, managed by the Smithsonian Institution, was established in 1846 century. It houses more than 12 crores, 120 million specimens of fossils and remains of plants and animals, mineral, rocks, human fossils and artifacts. Now, specimens of fossils, मतलब के जो ढांचा और plants वगैरह ये सब होते हैं, तो उनके जो बहुत सारे जो museums होते हैं, उनको जो क्या किया जाता है, उनके लिए जो क्या है क्या है, उनको वहाँ पर रखा जाता है. Human fossils and artifacts. उनके इंसानों के बचे हुए जो अंश होते हैं, जो जैसे हरप्पा एंड मोहनजोदड़ो में अगर कुछ ड्यूरिंग द एक्सकवेशन ऐसा कुछ मिलता है, या कोई और सिविलाइजेशन जो एक्सकवेट हुई है, फॉर एग्जाम्पल मेसोपोटामियन सिविलाइजेशन है, ग्रीक सिविलाइजेशन है, ऑल दीज सिविलाइजेशन रिमेन्स आर केप्ट इन दीज पर्टिकुलर म्यूजियम, आर्टिफैक्ट्स एंड म्यूजियम. Now in 2016, with 7.1 million visitors, it was the most visited museum in the world and the most visited natural history museum in the world. 7.1 million people in a year had visited this particular museum. And that's why this is the most, fourth most, yani puri duniya mein aisa chautha museum hai ye, jo duniya mein sabse zyada jo hai kya hai, visit kiya gaya. Located on the national in Washington is the United States. Washington जो है क्या है, capital है United States of America की, और वहीं पे ये है this particular museum. Now I'm sharing one particular video of the world famous museum. We'll just go through this video.
Consider yourself cultured, learned, knowledgeable, or just plain inquisitive. Then get yourself to these places. Welcome to WatchMojo.com, and today we're counting down our picks for the top 10 museums to visit. For this list, we've focused on museums that feature primarily art and historical artifacts. Subject-specific attractions have been excluded because, while these museums are fascinating and informative, we're choosing entries with a broader scope. Number 10. Rijksmuseum, Amsterdam. A grand building located within Amsterdam's Museum Square, the Rijksmuseum is the biggest, best, and most visited attraction of its type in the Netherlands. Established in 1800 and housing an incredibly vast collection with over 8,000 artifacts on show, including works by countrymen like Rembrandt and Vermeer, it's definitely not somewhere that can be skimmed over. One of the best examples of classic European celebration in the world. With its extensive combination of art and history, a day tripper to this place can expect to take in a masterpiece or two. Number 9, the National Archaeological Museum, Athens. In terms of historical significance, there aren't too many civilizations to trump ancient Greece. And in terms of celebrating that significance, there isn't a place that does it better than the National Archaeological Museum.
Yeah, now children, as you can see on the screen, किस तरह से जो है डिफरेंट वॉर के इक्विपमेंट्स है, उनके एम्बलम्स है, वो सब दिए हुए हैं यहाँ पर. जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस इज वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग.
Museum of Athens. The world renowned Acropolis is extremely good, but this place is just a little better. If you have a penchant for prehistory or a soft spot for sculpture, then this should be on your bucket list. With a library that's over a century old as an awesome added extra, one day just isn't enough. Number 8, the Vatican Museums. The religious and historical influence wielded by the Catholic Church is immense. Vatican City's museums more than reflect that. Visited by between 4 and 6 million people each year, the buildings in themselves are stunning, but the things they house are even better. Playing host to some of the most important artifacts from history, particularly from the Renaissance period, the museum deserves a pilgrimage of its very own. Michelangelo's Sistine Chapel is here, as are Raphael's Stanza della Signatura. It's a marvelous place that's difficult to believe actually exists outside of textbooks. Number 7, Museo del Prado. If you're interested in art, and even if you're not, this is a place that you simply must see. The National Art Museum of Spain, housed here, is one of the biggest. There seems a world-famous piece on almost every wall. You'll see Titian's The Fall. This place is another work of art within itself. Built in the latter half of the 16th century, this grandest of galleries has its two wings. Number 5, edge of Central Park. If the park is the city's lungs, then this place is its creative muse, with at least something from almost all of the European.
देखो अभी अभी जो हमने इनके बारे में पढ़े हैं अमेरिकन म्यूजियम ऑफ दी अमेरिकन म्यूजियम ऑफ नेशनल हिस्ट्री
नंबर 1 म्यूजी दु लूव्र
अभी हमने जो वर्ल्ड का जो सबसे फेमस म्यूजी दी लूव्र ये फ्रांस में है इट इज वन ऑफ द फर्स्ट म्यूजियम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड
वर्ल्ड्स मोस्ट विजिटेड म्यूजियम द लूव्र is a major landmark within the culture-laden city center of Paris. It's a combination of one of the world's finest historical records and one of the planet's best art galleries. The Venus de Milo, Rigaud's Louis XIV, Liberty Leading the People, Psyche Revived by Cupid's Kiss, all masterpieces. But pride of place goes to Da Vinci's Mona Lisa, a piece worth paying the admission fee for alone. But the Louvre has lots more to offer as well. The palace and the controversial glass pyramid are international icons. It's somewhere everyone should go and see at least once. Do you agree with our list? Which museum would you like to visit? For more cultured top 10s published every day, be sure to subscribe to watchmojo.com.
As we have seen, the different is museums of the world. So we have seen that how this culture has been preserved throughout these years. See, student museums are the places where the culture has been preserved of our world. मतलब कि जो पहले जमाने में जो culture था, उसके बाद जो जमाने में culture हुआ. Now again there are, I want to add some information to the museum is that there are different types of museums are there. अलग अलग types के जो क्या होते हैं museums होते हैं. Some are science museums, some are historical museums, geographical museums are there, cultural museums are there. Now whatever museums we have seen just now, these are the World Heritage Museums and the Greek civilization. For example, how we have kept our Ajanta and Ellora museums, उसी तरह उन्होंने भी उसको क्या Ajanta Ellora की जो paintings है किस तरह से वो caves में जो है क्या है safe है उसी तरह से लोगों ने कोशिश की है कि जो वो क्या करेंगे museums को क्या करके रखेंगे safe करके रखेंगे. Now again these museums are our heritage and we have to preserve these. Museums. Now all these preservation and conservation of museums to keep the artifacts, to make them to keep them for the exhibition, and all these paintings, art sculptures are antiques and they are very rare. They are only one in the whole world. एक ही जो है painting है जो world की जो जैसे कि for example you have just seen the painting of Mona Lisa which is kept in Louvre Museum, France. Now that is only one painting which has been painted by Leonardo Vinci. So वो एक ही painting है. So you can understand the importance of that particular painting. इसीलिए जो है क्या है, students, these museums और इनकी जो है क्या है, बहुत ज़्यादा security भी की जाती है. These museum has been specially curated. उनकी क्योंकि करोड़ों and even in the dollars. In million dollars, there the value of that these particular paintings or the art or the sculpture are in crores rupees. So again, to maintain that particular things is also very important and need an experts. इसके लिए जो है क्या है हमको experts की जरूरत पड़ती है और जो time and again जो है क्या है जो है उनकी security को जो है maintain किया जाता है और उनको रिवाइव भी किया जाता है. और कभी कभी देखा होगा कि किस तरह से जो है कभी कभी म्यूजियम्स में चोरी हो जाती है और उनके आर्टिफैक्ट्स को क्या किया जाता है, चोरी किया जाता है. द रीजन इज दैट दोज आर्टिफैक्ट्स आर वेरी रेयर, दोज आर्टिफैक्ट्स आर वेरी कॉस्टली एंड वेरी रेयर एंड पीपल नीड टू बी एक्स्ट्रा केयरफुल व्हाइल हैंडलिंग दोज आर्टिफैक्ट्स. नाउ नेक्स्ट यू कैन सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन म्यूजियम्स इन इंडिया. अभी जो है हमने क्या देखा है, इंडिया के जो है हमने जो आर्ट एंड आर्टिफैक्ट्स देखा, अभी वर्ल्ड का देखा. नाउ अगेन आई विल शेयर माय स्क्रीन और हम लोग देखेंगे अभी इंडिया के जो है क्या है म्यूजियम्स को हम लोग क्या करने वाले हैं, देखने वाले हैं. Now, as you can see, top 10 museums in India.
Number 1.
India के जो 10 ऐसे museums हैं जो बहुत ज़्यादा क्या है, famous है. We'll see this.
National Museum, Delhi. Established in 1949, the National Museum of India in New Delhi is home to an impressive collection of displays and exhibits. The displays chronicle the history of India right from the days of the Mohenjo-Daro and Harappan civilization to modern times. On display are relics dating back to the Vedic civilization. The personal effects of Gautam Buddha, arms and weapons used by Indian kings over the centuries, including an elephant's armor, artwork, wood carvings, textiles, music instruments, and sculptures. A tour of the museum promises to be a fantastic experience. Number 2. Indian Museum, Kolkata. The Indian Museum was established in 1814 by the Asiatic Society. At the time, Calcutta was the capital of British India and remained the seat of political and cultural development for...
As you can see on the screen, yahan pe jo hai ek जो एनिमल का जो है फॉसिल्स जो है रिमेन है उसको इरेक्ट करके रखा गया है. यू कैन सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन लेफ्ट हैंड साइड आल्सो देयर इज वन स्केलेटन इज देयर. ओके, सो ऑल दीज आर द फॉसिल रिमेन्स ऑफ द एनिमल्स व्हिच वाज फाउंड ड्यूरिंग द एक्सकवेशन.
A century. No wonder the Indian Museum is oldest museum in Southeast Asia and the largest in the country. It is divided into 6 sections with a total of 35 galleries. The artifacts and displays are classified into archaeology, art, anthropology, botany, geology, and zoology. Number 3. Salar Jung Museum, Hyderabad. The Salar Jung Museum of Hyderabad is probably one of the...
Salar Jung, Hyderabad, full city is there, which is Ramoji Film City. Again, that is also considered as one of the museum of India, because all over the world, whenever people visit, and whether they make sure to go to the Ramoji Film City, because if you'll go to that particular film city, you'll find different kinds of features, artifacts, different scenes, how the movies has been shot, किस तरह से शूटिंग की जाती है. सो ऑल दोस एंड सालार जंग म्यूजियम अगेन वन ऑफ द फेमस म्यूजियम ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. ऑल द एंटिक्स आइटम्स फ्रॉम द रेन ऑफ टीपू सुल्तान हैदर अली व्हिच हैज देयर होल लाइफ देयर बुक्स अगेन देयर डिफरेंट वॉर इक्विपमेंट्स हैज बीन केप्ट इन सालार जंग म्यूजियम.
Known in the country, the museum was established in 1951 at the palace of Nawab Mir Yusuf Khan, popularly known as Salar Jung Sri. The museum houses a collection of over 1.1 million artifacts and art pieces, all personally collected by Salar Jung Sri himself. One of the best collections here is the clock room, a gallery of clocks and timekeeping devices from across the world from historical times. Number 4, the Prince of Wales Museum, Mumbai. Despite being renamed Chhatrapati Shivaji Vastu Sangram.
Now see, if you have visited, if you have went to the picnic, Mumbai Darshan, agar aap, if in your primary, I think, we used to take the students for the Mumbai Darshan. And in that, one of the places is this Prince of Wales Museum. This was, now it was renamed as Shivaji Chhatrapati Maharaj Museum. Now this particular museum is in Mumbai, and you might have visited this particular place. It's again very important very important museum of India. Now this particular museum has 3 sections. 3 sections ko divide kiya gaya hai, historical, natural heritage, and science. We'll see this.
Earlier, this museum is still called the Prince of Wales Museum. The museum was set up in 1922 to commemorate the Prince's visit to India. Among the exhibits here are some ancient relics from the Indus Valley civilization, some magnificent sculptures from the Middle Ages, artwork in miniature paintings, pottery and porcelain ware, and a fine display of ancient Indian weapons of war. The dome structure in which the museum is located is a beautiful blend of Hindu, Islamic, and British architecture and was designed by George Witt. Number 5, Government Museum, Chennai. The Government Museum of Chennai, often called the Egmore Museum due to its location in Egmore, is housed in the Panthan Complex, a beautiful colonial building. This museum showcases one of the most impressive exhibits from South Indian history, the bronze sculpture collection. This gallery has on display bronze sculptures dating back to the 7th century Pallava time, but some of the best pieces come from the Chola Empire from between the 9th and 11th centuries. Number 6, National Rail Museum, Delhi. The National Railway Museum, located in Chennai Kapuri, New Delhi, is a great favorite with children and rail enthusiasts. Spread over an area of about 11 acres, the museum showcases the evolution of railways in India. Apart from the collection of steam engines and locomotive carriages, it also features special carriages such as the former Visaragal dining car and the Maharajas of Mysore's rolling saloon. The Fairy Queen locomotive is also part of the display here. The indoor display includes a great collection of old photographs, trains from bygone times. Number 7, Calico Museum of Textiles, Ahmedabad. Fabrics and textiles have formed an important part of Indian trade and heritage. Showcasing the splendor of Indian looms and textiles is the Calico Museum of Textile in Ahmedabad. Not only does the museum display ancient textiles and clothes made in India during the Mughal era, it also chronicles the progress of the textile industry in different parts of the country. Don't miss out on the display of the fine Kashmiri pashminas and rugs and the Ikat hand looms. Number 8, Shankar's International Dolls Museum, Delhi. India is the land of dolls. They are used as idols for stories, toys, and for a number of cultural purposes. Shankar's International Dolls Museum in Delhi houses one of the largest collection of dolls in the country. The galleries of this museum include an impressive display of dolls from various parts of India and also from some 85 other countries, from Japanese geisha dolls to Spanish flamenco dancer dolls, from American farmer dolls to Thai women's orchestra. The museum takes on a tour of the world. Number 9, Napier Museum, Thiruvananthapuram. Named after Sir John Napier, the former Governor General of Madras, the Napier Museum is located in a beautiful Indo-Star scenic structure right in the heart of Thiruvananthapuram. The museum is home to the stunning variety of displays from South India. Special emphasis, however, is on the woods, bronze and ivory carvings and artifacts from Kerala. The museum has a special collection of Hindu gods idols from Kerala and Tamil Nadu. Do not miss the Ramayana and Mahabharata exhibits, which have been fashioned out of Japanese leather dolls. Number 10, HAL Heritage Center and Aerospace Museum, Bangalore. One of the most interesting museums across the country is the HAL Heritage Center and Aerospace Museum. The museum was established in 2001 by Hindustan Aeronautics Limited to showcase the aviation history and developments across the years. The museum has a wonderful display of models of aero engines. There are some real engines on display too. These belong to Dornier, Jaguar, and Kiran artifacts. Hope you like this video. For more videos, please subscribe to our channel.
My student, as you have seen, we have discussed about the we have discussed the different museums in India. Now we'll see the detailed explanation. So the first museum in India established as Indian Museum was established by Asiatic Society of Bengal in Kolkata in 1814 century. Now see children, it's what it was during the British's time. That's first museum of India has been established, and it was basically started by Asiatic Society of Bengal. Then the second museum in India is Government Museum, was established in Chennai in 1851. We have just seen the videos or the actual visuals of these museums. The reason to show that particular museum, see, museum is something which is a very interesting topic. And I just cannot read the lines and explain you, because if you have really interest in your history, not only in history, if you want to know something about the past related with all your subjects, related with the science, technology, even related with railways, okay, whatever field you want to know history of that particular subject, you can visit the museum, and it's very thrilling experience. You might have, some of you might have visited the museums. So when you'll walk through the museums, the feeling of walking through it, when you'll walk through the museums, you'll find that as if we are walking, or as if we are in that particular period. For example, if ancient period museum is there, आप जब उसमें जाओगे वहां पे आप वॉक करोगे तो आपको समझ में आएगा कि हाउ interesting was to visit the museum. So again, it is very important topic, and that's why I have shown you the videos. Now, third one is the National Museum was established in Delhi in the year 1949. Presently, there are several museums in various states of India. In today's time, we'll find different museum in each of the city. We have just seen the top 10 museums of India. The reason is that throughout the time, the importance of museum has been increased, and the people started investing in the museums, and especially the government has started preserving the heritage, because museums are the best place to preserve our heritage. Unless we will not keep our heritage at bay, then only we can continue with the our historical importance. Now again, usually the big museums have their own archives and libraries. Some museums are affiliated to universities. Such museums are also offers course in museology. Now see children, what actually the museology is. Museology is a course which you can do after your graduation, and if you complete your museology course, you'll able to work as a professional, as a profession personal person in the field of museums. For example, museum aise hi nahi khud se chal jate. We need to require experts help to run the museums. For example, to maintain the artifacts in the museum, to take care of those museum artifacts, to preserve the books in the library, okay, and to clean those artifacts. We cannot clean those artifacts with any liquid or any chemical. We need to have the good experts, because if they'll react with the artifacts, that particular artifacts will destroy. So, and we cannot get back that particular artifact, because those are antiques, and we need to have the expert for that particular field. Now, following are some of the well-known institutes and archives which offer degree and diploma courses in museology. Now, these are the some of the institutes that if you want to pursue your career in museology or library science, you can go for these particular universities which are offering career in your museology department. Now, first one is National Museum at Delhi. It's situated in Delhi. Second, Maharaja Sayaji Rao University, Vadodara. It's in Gujarat. Third, Kolkata University, again in Kolkata. Banaras Hindu University, Varanasi. It's in UP. Then fifth, Aligarh Muslim University, Aligarh. Again, it's in UP. Shivaji University, Gwalior. Then, would you like to know this? Then some famous museums of India are as follows. The following are some of the famous museums in India. Indian Museum, Kolkata. National Museum, Delhi. Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj, Vastu Garandharal, Mumbai. Salar Jung Museum, Hyderabad. And Calcutta Museum of Textile, Ahmedabad. We have just seen all these important museums. Now we'll see one by one the detailed information about these museums. Then first one is Chhatrapati Shivaji Vastu Granthale. Now see, earlier the name of this particular museum was Prince of Wales Museum, as we have seen the video. Okay, this museum established in the year 1904. Some influential residents of Mumbai decided to establish a museum to commemorate the visit of Prince of Wales into India. Okay, now particular some of the influential persons, maybe industrialists, business persons, or some wealthy person have decided to create this. In the month of November of 1905, the foundation was laid, the museum building. It was decided that the name of the museum would be Prince of Wales Museum of Western India. It was renamed as Chhatrapati Shivaji Maharaj Vastu Granthalaya in 1998. The building of the museum is built in Indo-Gothic style. Now, if you have seen the museum, or if you have seen, as you have seen in the video also, that particular museum is built in a dome shape. Uske upar gumbad hai building ke, to wo Indo-Gothic, means India or jo India aur India ki jo Gothic cultures hai. For example, like temples we have, like we have masjid, on that particular pattern, that particular museum has been erected. It has been given the status of Grade 1 heritage building in Mumbai. Grade 1. That means that particular building is very important and very essential
and thousands of people are visiting every day that particular museum. If you have seen the museum, it's very, very, it's very beautiful museum. I personally visited that particular place, different departments of there, for example, and that particular museum is especially for the historical artifacts, historical artifacts rakhe gaye hain wahan pe, right from the ancient artifacts to medieval artifacts to modern artifacts. Even when I have visited all the war equipments from the medieval period, for example, पोशाक कैसे पहनते थे, फॉर एग्जाम्पल फ्रॉम द मुगल, वन ऑफ द मुगल एम्परर अकबर, हाउ पोशाक कैसे पहनते थे ड्यूरिंग द वॉर, उनके ऊपर जो वॉर से बचने के लिए वो जो उनकी बर्शियां यूज करते थे, वॉट आर द डिफरेंट डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ ज्वेलरीज दे यूज टू वेयर, ऑल दैट हैज बीन kept over there, वहां पे वो रखी गई है, एंड इट्स वेरी नाइस टू सी ऑल दोस थिंग्स. Because we cannot go to that particular period. हम वहाँ पर अब तो नहीं जा सकते, but by seeing those particular artifacts, we can feel the our pride. हम जो उस ज़माने में जो हमारा culture था, हमारा जो traditions था, we can feel and we can experience those particular by seeing those artifacts. The museum houses about 50,000 antiquities divided into three categories: art, archaeology, and natural history. As I have told you, that particular museum has different categories. I think that particular museum has three or four four floor, three or four stories ki hai wo building. And again, on each floor there is different section is there: art, archaeology, and natural history. Now, children, as you all that museum is one of the integral part of our history. See, for example, now whenever it comes to our mind that we want to experience some historical things, we can visit to the museum and make sure at least visit museums to encourage our cultural heritage. Because in museums we have different our cultural heritage, our natural heritage, our historical heritage. All these are having some or other heritage only, and that's why these are very important. It is very important and essential to visit the museums. Again, if we want to make career in museology, or if you want to make career in museology, and if you want to be part of the museum, or if you want to be expert in the field of museum. Or you want to research an artifacts, again you can take history as at your higher level. Up history ko higher level pe pursue kar sakte ho after your 12th standard. You can make history as your major subject at graduation level, and then you can definitely complete your course of museology, which is offered by different institute. As you can see, I have just named the different institute in India which are offering museology courses. So when you'll complete this course, again it's very interesting branch of the history, where you can get a direct experience to work as a researcher, as an historian, to maintain all these artifacts. If you want to make career in history, again you can make the career history. As here again I want to say, or I want to tell you all that history is not just a subject which you can only study and forget. Aisa nahi hai ki history ko aap se padho aur bhul jao. History is a subject you can actually practice in your day-to-day life, or you can make career in your history subject if you have interest in your particular subject. Okay, students, so here yahan par main jo hai abhi lecture ko wind up kar rahi hu, aur I want to tell you all that we have finished with the two parts of this particular lesson, that is called natural heritage management. In the first part we have dealt with how these experts actually manage our material
material sources, especially artifacts, how these are managed by the experts and scholars of the history. And in the second part, that is today, we have seen the famous museums. That famous museum has been divided into two different categories, that is Indian museums and the museums of the world. And in that also, in Indian museum, you have seen that how the different museums are there, museum related with the cotton textile, museums related with agriculture, museum related with railways, again with history, science, war equipments, information and technology. So there are different categories in which we have the different museums. So I hope कि आपको ये अभी तक का समझ में आया होगा. एंड विद दिस आई एम एंडिंग माय लेक्चर.
Hello, Nazira ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, what happened? Screen is not visible.
Ma'am, just now I have stopped sharing.
Acha, your lecture is over?
Yes.
But still we have time, ma'am. It's 10:29 till 10:35. We have still 5-6 minutes. So can you do some question
10:30, answer? Madam, 10:30 is there, na? 9:15 to 10:30.
10:35, ma'am. Still we have 5-6 minutes. So can you do some question answering session or...
No, ma'am, I'll start with the next topic, no problem.
Okay, please do that because we have time still, okay?
Okay, students, one of the another part of our the lesson is that libraries and archives, as we have discussed, that again libraries books are one of the important sources of the source to get the knowledges. Okay, and historical books are again our heritage. Bahut purani books hain aapke textbooks jo aaj aap pad rahe ho, literally not I'm not talking about these books, but the books which are written 500 years back or 600 back, these books are very essential and important. So again, now we'll study that how these books are managed and preserved by our researchers. Libraries are storehouse of the knowledge and information. Yes, in libraries we keep the books. We keep the books which are full of knowledges, and that's why libraries are called as one of the storehouse of the knowledge and information. मतलब कि वहाँ पे books, यानी जो खजाना होता है knowledge का, वो हम जो है क्या है रखे थे. So again, libraries has to be maintained and preserved by our government. So that's why there are different libraries which offer great information about our past, culture and tradition. Now, library science is very closely related to management science, information technology, and the field of education. There are different books which are different on different subjects. Now, library science is very closely related to management science, information technology, and in the field of education. Now, see children, nowadays the importance of books has been reduced, and information technology has came into limelight. But again, if we'll see 100 years back, books are very important source of information. Now, library perform various tasks like collecting books, arranging them systematically, conservation and preservation of those books, dissemination of information and sources. Now, collecting books, again, arranging them systematically, conservation and preservation of those books, dissemination of information and sources. Many of these tasks are completed with the help of computerized system. Many of the tasks are completed with the help of computerized system. Now see children, if in a library there are many thousands of books are there, then how you will going to see or how you will going to find a particular book. So there is particular system or there is a particular procedure to manage those books. For example, categories has been made. Books libraries keep under categories नहीं जाती है. If you have visited some libraries, अगर आपने कभी library देखा होगा तो आपको पता होगा कि library में क्या बनाया जाता है, categories बनाई जाती है, जिसकी वजह से जो क्या होता है, हम लोग easily किसी भी book को क्या कर सकते हैं, find कर सकते हैं. For example, in a library there are different books are kept related with science, history, geography, literature. और इन डिफरेंट लैंग्वेजेस आल्सो, हिंदी, मराठी, इंग्लिश, संस्कृत, पर्शियन, अरेबिक. सो व्हाट विल विल गो व्हेन विल गो टू द पर्टिकुलर लाइब्रेरी, सो वी वांट टू रीड द बुक और हमको वो बुक जल्दी से मिलनी चाहिए. मैक्स टू मैक्स 2 to 3 मिनट्स में या 5 मिनट्स में वी नीड टू फाइंड दैट पर्टिकुलर बुक एंड वी वांट टू रीड. सो इन 1000 बुक्स हाउ यू आर गोइंग टू फाइंड दैट पर्टिकुलर बुक. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू रीड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ मराठा by G.P. Gokhale. I'm just giving an example. Okay, now this is English language book of a Marathi of a related with Maratha, history of Maratha. So how you're going to find that particular book? So you will, if you'll go to the librarian, she'll just see the name. She'll just enter that particular name in the computer. Wo computer mein wo naam type karegi and automatically in an Excel sheet wo saamne aa jayega ki wo kaun si cupboard mein, kaun section mein, so not इन कबर्ड, वो कौन से सेक्शन में, कौन से रूम नंबर में, कौन से कबर्ड के अंदर, कौन सी रो में रखी हुई है, कितने नंबर पर. ओके, बिकॉज इफ वेन एवर यूल कीप टेक आउट दैट पर्टिकुलर बुक, आप जब वो बुक निकाल सकते हो वहां पर जाके वो आपको बता देंगे कि आप ये रूम में जाइए, रूम नंबर 101 में जाइए, यूल गो टू द सेकेंड योर थर्ड कबर्ड, फोर्थ कबर्ड, वट एवर द नंबर ऑफ द कबर्ड, एंड देन वहां जाके आप उसको जो है थर्ड या फोर्थ रो में जाके आप वो बुक जो है आपको मिल जाएगी. एंड व्हेन एवर यू विल कंप्लीट द रीडिंग ऑफ दैट पर्टिकुलर बुक, आपको वहां जाके उसी जगह पर वो क्या करनी है, बुक को रख देना है. सो नेक्स्ट टाइम इफ अनदर पर्सन वांट टू टेक दैट पर्टिकुलर बुक, सो दैट पर्टिकुलर पर्सन विल गेट दैट बुक. बट मैनेजिंग दिस सिस्टम इज रिक्वायर एन एक्सपर्ट. इस सिस्टम को बनाने के लिए और इस सिस्टम को मेंटेन करने के लिए वी नीड अ पर्टिकुलर एक्सपर्ट और उसको हम बोलते हैं लाइब्रेरियन. उसको हम बोलते हैं लाइब्रेरियन जो उस चीज को क्या करता है, मेंटेन करता है, उनको बुक को लेबल करता है, बुक को जो है कैटेगरीज में डिवाइड करता है. सो वी नीड अ पर्टिकुलर एक्सपर्ट और उसको हम बोलते हैं लाइब्रेरियन. और लाइब्रेरियन भी जैसे मैंने आपको बताया कि म्यूजियोलॉजी का एक कोर्स होता है, उसी तरह लाइब्रेरी का भी क्या होता है, एक कोर्स होता है. और उसको जब हम कोई लाइब्रेरी को मेंटेन करता है उसको हम बोलते हैं लाइब्रेरियन. To make a book available to a reader as per his requirement is the most important aspects of library management. The Royal Library of the again children, now we'll complete this particular topic next time. We'll make just revision. हम लोग जो next time start करेंगे हम topic, तो हम लोग उसको revise करेंगे और ये topic को क्या करेंगे, complete करेंगे. Thank you.
Okay, thank you, ma'am. Students, if you are having any doubts, raise your hands. Students.